Shabi, as a CEO and as a woman, I feel that you're so close to the customer. You're in Dubai and you have friends in Dubai and you know their taste. And I see the creations are made as if tailor-made to the woman. You know who you're targeting.
That's true.
Being so close to the media, to the customer, being so humble, how much is helping you to reach the woman with the right designs?
Probably a lot. I have to say that it's very genuine first. I really love the region and I love the woman here. Being a woman also helps to project yourself into really what you desire and the offerings that you want. And yes, we are very close to, it's very historical. The partnership and the relation between Piaget and the region has been more than 60 years of relationship. We were one of the first brands to really come to Dubai and in the region. So we have this very close relationship, and of course the Dubai woman, and let's say more than Dubai, the UAE and the GCC region, the women, I always felt that they have this they're a trendsetter. They know what they like, they know how to express themselves. And I think it's also something that inspires us a lot. And we have a lot of creation, as you said, that are inspired by the region, inspired by the lifestyle, inspired
how
by
they
the
wear
energy.
The jewelry.
Absolutely, the way it's worn. For example, the stackability that you have here, the fact that you like sautoir also.
The choice of even of the precious stones as well, like
yes,
or semi-precious like the malachite, how much here it stands yes. out when you're wearing a black
it's
abaya.
It's true.
And the size of the necklace as well to
yes.
stand out. So I feel yes. everything is so targeted for the region as a
yes,
special treatment we're
it
having.
It is a special treatment, absolutely.
Yeah. Tell me about the amazing
so for example,
piece of art.
Yeah, so if we take this, it's a very brand new collection, Infinite Sun, that we're launching here in Dubai during this after Dubai week. And it has been completely inspired by the region. It's a sun element. As you know, Piaget has always had a very positive outlook of the world, where we have all this very strong solar energy. And for me, it's Dubai, right? It's the region.
Yeah.
It's being very dynamic, very playful, very open, very bright. And everything that we feel here is really embedded into this spirit of this collection.
Amazing.
And so we used a kind of a very interesting abstract sun design with different stones. So we have an opal, we have a lapis, you will see also later, and we have the malachite here.
And I love the ring, the cocktail ring coming along.
Yes, we have a very nice
and different
collection.
Colors
absolutely.
And stones.
Very nice collection of hard stones with precious stones. Rings, like cocktail rings, and as you can see, we have lapis with Paraiba, we have diamonds with chalcedony, and we have this one which is malachite with peridot.
Love it. Tell me about the watches. On which watch you're betting for 2018?
Definitely on the Possession, because we are launching a new watch that goes very much in line with the jewelry. So with the same very bright colors, we work on lapis, on turquoise, on malachite, on cornaline. So it all goes together. It is very feminine also. We still have a bezel turning, so it's a very exciting watch. But also it's true that here, if we talk about the region, there is a special crush and a special love for the gold and the work on gold.
And going back to the heritage
exactly.
and the classic watches.
Absolutely. And again, it's going back to the heritage, but still being able to project it in the future.
Mm-hmm.
So it's still the same work of art. So we still have all the hand engraving.
Amazing craftsmanship.
Absolutely. It's really very
how
supple.
Thin and easy to wear.
Absolutely. And if you look at the different designs also, they're very creative and they definitely express something different from one piece to the other. And it's always like a unique piece. Because the stone, the hard stone in the middle is always a bit different.
Definitely. Tell me about the new trend that you're launching, like in jewelry. I see going back to the manchette as well,
yes.
more and more this year.
Yes, like, it's true. But again, as I said, we were really looking at the signature of Piaget and we're bringing that in the forefront. So typically everything we have with the hard stones and also the manchette, Piaget has been really one of the first to really do a fusion between jewelry and watches. On the cuffs, but also on the sautoir watch. And yes, we have always, throughout the years, we always had big manchettes. It's very also empowering, I think, as a piece of jewelry.
Definitely. I love how you're becoming a brand that is setting trends. And I see you like watching my earrings and seeing the trends in the region. So you go back to Geneva and maybe come up with a new brief
Absolutely.
Or something new. Tell me, what are you looking at now?
We're always being very much inspired again by the region. And we have more to come around the sun and around other collections that are very inspired by the region. Yes.
Back to empowering women. I see your team now are becoming all powerful women.
Yes.
And how does it happen that unconsciously you're empowering women by recruiting very strong women
yes,
and on high positions, and now
yes.
all Piaget upper management are women?
Yes, it's true, more and more. It's not done in purpose. Of course, I try to find the best talents. Mm-hmm. But it's true that I'm very lucky to have now a majority of my executive committee and a lot of directors are women. It's beautiful to see that. I think it's fair to have always a right equilibrium between men and women. So I'm very proud to have a team that has been able to work all together, being men, women. This is what we want at Diana, a good representation, not only also in terms of gender, but also in terms of nationalities. We have more and more now people coming from different countries, and that is helping a lot to also get closer to the clients.
What are the main pillars of applying leadership in your team? Like, we see a successful company, Piaget is growing, the name is growing. So tell me.
I have, yes, a leadership style that is probably into coaching. So we try to work in a very transversal way. We work being very open-minded. I listen a lot to a lot of people. To make sure it's not only a top-down organization, so it's not only very directive, we try to have a lot of discussion, being iterative, and I think that's where we have the best ideas. When we're open to different points of views, where we're open to challenge and being able to be challenged. And I think that's not always easy, but it's what I like. I like to be challenged by my teams also.
Do you promise Dubai also another Art Dubai next year?
As we say here, inshallah.
So you're on a global level and yes. on a regional level.
Yes.
That makes us so happy. Thank you so much,
Shabi.
So happy to talk to you.
It was a pleasure. Thank you, Zoya.